guys. Please write down, venturi meter is a device. Venturi meter is a device to measure the flow rate. To measure the flow rate of the fluid. It helps us to measure the flow rate of the fluid. Now you will say, oh, it is so easy. Flow rate is A into V only. But suppose you don't know what is V. Are you getting my point? If you don't know what is V, then you have to measure it somehow. It is one way to write down, okay, flow rate is A into V, so easy, go and calculate it. But if water is flowing in a pipe, you have no idea with what velocity it is flowing in a pipe, you should have a device to measure the flow rate, and that is what the venturi meter is. Okay, so let's see how it works. First, we'll see how it looks. Venturi meter looks like this. Draw it with me. अब इसमें क्या बात करना है तुमको? What do you have to discuss here? Oh, venturi meter. What? Your name is? No. His name? It's what? Vedan.
Dhyan.
Dhyan which has H in it. Double A, right? Double A. H in it. ओके ध्यान ला के देखो. डोंट टॉक. व्हाट आर यू टॉकिंग? वेदर यू कैन जस्ट लीव इट.
नो, दिस आर टीच इन स्कूल.
तो उसमें मैं क्या करूं? तो आर यू प्रिपेयरिंग अ लिस्ट? ओके, सर हैज टॉट दिस बट ही हैज टॉट दिस. व्हाट इज द पॉइंट ऑफ दैट? यू हैव टू लर्न इट. इट इज इन योर स्कूल टेक्स्ट बुक. व्हेन बोर्ड पेपर इज सेट, nobody cares about who has taught you what. In board exam, some external person will send the paper. Okay? Venturi meter is there in your syllabus. This is how venturi meter looks, and don't talk. This is how venturi meter looks. Alright, and it is a very small device, probably this much, okay, only this much. For a pipe of this thickness, this is the actual thickness of the pipe. If your pipe has this much thickness, then your venturi meter will be something of this size only. The pipe can go on and on. Okay, so this is how much is the size of a venturi meter. And this is how it looks. So I have enlarged it and drawn. Okay? And this is fitted in between the pipe. While water is flowing inside the pipe itself, it encounters the venturi meter. Okay? So your pipe is there. In between the pipe, there is a venturi meter. Okay? This cross-section area of both sides of the venturi meter will be same. And since you have created venturi meter, you have probably measured it. What is the area of cross section and diameter of venturi meter? So these things are known to you. Okay? Capital A is known to you, and small a is the cross section area of the neck. That is also known to you. Have you done manometer?
Yeah.
Good. Manometer. Huh? No, I don't remember. I am teaching the same thing to four different classes. In one of the class, I have missed manometer. So, I have to teach manometer before venturi meter. So, I have done manometer, right? I don't create a list that in NPS I have. What is a joke? तो why are you laughing? तो क्या मतलब है? खड़ा हो जा, खड़ा हो। Sorry क्या sorry? तू joke बनाएगा तो खड़ा हो जा। क्या क्या joke चल रहा है? हाँ? The way I?
The way you open the door.
I haven't opened the door. So he opened the door and you started laughing. Sorry? So you typically laugh when door gets open? So at home, how many times you laugh?
The way he opened it.
The way he क्या क्या typical है ना तेरा? So it is about Arman. But the same thing. Oh, right? Some other joke is there. Okay, focus here. It's a ventilometer. Pay some respect. Let's say velocity V1 is there. Stop talking. Stop talking. The construction of ventilometer is like this. This is the manometer that is connected between the two areas of cross section. We'll discuss how it is useful, but right now you first draw it. This is V1, this is V2. The ventilometer is typically horizontal. So you don't need to worry about the height difference. Okay? Now, suppose P1 is pressure over here and P2 is pressure over there. Okay? Can you find out the flow rate in terms of P1, P2, capital A and small a? The flow rate is how much? You multiply capital A with V1 or small a with V2. Both are same. Because that is a continuity equation. Capital A into V1 is small a into V2. Right? So please find out what is the value of V1 and V2. Very similar to the previous question. In fact, simpler than that. Just write down continuity equation and Bernoulli's theorem. And find out V1 and V2. From continuity and Bernoulli's theorem, find out V1 and V2. Density is given as rho. Okay, but capital A is square over, na? Alright, so now I'll write down capital A into V1 is small a into V2. Dot dot. Then, which are my 2 points? Point number one, point number two. Between these 2 points, I have to write continuity equation and Bernoulli's equation. Okay? So P1 plus, stop talking. I'll just pick someone and ask him or her to leave. If talking. That someone could be anyone. See, I can use this as my reference line. So I can say H1 and H2 both are zero. Okay, so rho g h will not appear itself. So p1 plus half rho v1 square is equal to p2 plus half rho v2 square. Now tell me where the pressure will be more. P1 is more or p1 is p2 is more?
P2.
Are you telling me where velocity is more?
V2 velocity.
V2 is more? So half rho v2 square is more than half rho v1 square? So P1 should be more than P2. This is more than that, and sum of this and that is constant. So if, chalo, let's, if you're not getting it, let's say this is 10 and this is 100. Then if this is 20, how much this should be? 110, because sum should be constant. That is why P1 is more than P2, since this is greater than that. So we have seen that if velocity along the streamline is more, pressure drops. It is like saying that kinetic energy at that point has increased. So pressure energy will decrease. Some of the energy is constant. Pressure is also energy. Pressure energy per unit volume. So if kinetic energy per unit volume increases, pressure energy per unit volume decreases. Same. Okay. So that is why people say that do not go near to a moving train. The air which is next to the moving train is moving very fast. So pressure, that point is lesser than pressure on the platform. So the air behind you can push you towards the train. Okay? Be careful.
Sir, I'm not laughing, sir.
Some similar incidents? Something similar? What are you talking about? Focus here. V2 is equal to capital A by small a into V1. Okay? Now substitute that. So you get P1 minus P2 is equal to half of rho into V1 square capital A by small a whole square minus 1. This is what you will get. Okay. So, if you rearrange the terms, you are going to get V1 is equal to root over 2 times P1 minus P2 divided by rho into capital A by small a whole square minus 1. Please write this down. Write this down. How many of you got this? Close to this. Typically, the objective paper options are very close to each other. So if you get close to it, you don't get zero. Get minus one. Be careful. All of you getting this? How it comes? How it comes? Okay. Now tell me, how will you, see here, density is known, capital A is known, small a is known. But P1 and P2 are not known to me. Although I got the expression, I got in terms of P1 and P2. So there should be a way to measure P1 minus P2. And that is using manometer, that is the manometer is there. Are you getting it? So, since P1 is more than P2, so this kind of scenario will happen if there is a fluid inside the manometer, it will get pushed from this side more. Yes or no? Okay. Now you are using water in the pipe, so you should better use a heavier fluid inside the manometer, and that is mercury. Okay, so let's say this is mercury, density of mercury is rho n. Alright, and let's say the height difference is h. Okay, now tell me one thing, will the pressure change from this point to that point? This is filled with water. Water will come inside, this is water. And here is also water. So there will be pressure variation from this point to that point?
Yes, sir.
Right? But we are ignoring that because density of mercury is very high. It is like, it is similar to when you ignore pressure variation in a gas because density is very less. So similar kind of scenario when you are using mercury. Although pressure variation is there, but you are ignoring that. So pressure over here, I can say it is P1, and pressure over there I can say it is P2. So what is the relation between P1 and P2? What is the relation? Quick. Just tell me the relation. If you draw a horizontal line here, pressure over here should be what?
P1.
So P1 should be equal to? P1 is more than P2, na?
Yes, sir.
And P1 is below from this point, so the pressure here will be more. You forgotten that law itself. You're telling me minus. So P1 minus P2 is how much? Rho m gh. How do you know what is h? You will have a scale over here. Put a scale over here. You can easily measure what is h. Right? So h can be measured easily. So now I can substitute the values what I can measure. So the answer to it is P1 minus P2 is rho m gh. The 2 times rho mercury gh divided by, this is density of water, okay? This rho and that rho don't cancel out. A2 by small a, the whole square minus 1. This is velocity v1 in terms of what you can calculate directly. H I can calculate, capital A cap I can calculate, and small a also I can calculate. Fine?
Density of water.
Density of water to known, hai na, universally. That is 1000. Okay, any doubt? So flow rate is how much? This into? Which A? This into capital A or small a? Capital A. V1 is a velocity near the capital A. So capital A into V1 is the flow rate, which is capital Q. So capital Q is this flow rate. This much volume of water is flowing per second in the pipe. Are you getting it? Right? This is how you analyze the entire venturimeter. Any doubt?